Yes, people, what's good and welcome back to the channel. So today is the fourth day of my birthday. I'm just going to do a quick video and a quick update on the Pico reef and issues I've been having. Now, as we know, in the UK, we've been on lockdown since like last year, March. And when you're in lockdown and it's your birthday, there's about four things that you can do. You can eat, drink, sleep, and find other things to do. Dirty mind. Now, as you guys know, that the Pico reef belongs to my daughter, Naira. So this week what I've done is I've actually done a massive boo boo on my part. Last week I took out some of the filter media or filtration, biological filtration in the system, so all the rocks and stuff like that. I took it out and I said to myself, look, let me just give this a little clean, a little tidy. But what I did was I actually killed, this is so rookie, I killed the bacteria out there because I submerged the rock, the whole bag of rocks, into fresh water rather than the same water that came from the tank. Now I didn't do this like over like a couple of seconds, I left it there for a couple of hours and the temperature dropped. So I think all the bacteria that were on the beneficial bacteria literally just died off. So what's happening to the Pico reef is going through like a little cycle again. So I could see things like cyano growing up on the sand bed, which is fine, it's cool. But what I was noticing as well, that the sand bed itself had become a nutrient sink. So I was doing all these water changes. I said to myself, hold on, it's a Pico reef, so maybe I don't need to do the sand bed. So during last week or this week, I've been just fluffing up the sand bed using a turkey baster, getting all that muck out. I actually replaced the filter brick that was in there, the filter sponge, with just regular filter floss to catch all those particulates and bits of uneaten food. Now, where it gets really bad with the Pico reef, I added some SPS in there about a month ago, yeah? And I recently added another piece of SPS there for my daughter, which was doing really, really well. But because of the whole nutrient thing, and I reckon the phosphates were quite high because the water was dirty, was black. And I kind of regret I didn't take a video or picture for you guys to see, but it was terrible, the water change I did on there and all the crap that was in the back chamber of the Pico. So guys, I decided to replace the filter sponge back here with normal filter floss. So this is very fine and the water can actually get polished or get cleaned a bit better before it enters the rear chamber. So this will kind of get replaced like every other day, get the crap out of there like what I used to do, what I do on my main tank. And the mistake I made was with the filter media at the back here, where I took the Ziporax and submerged it for a couple of hours into fresh water. Okay, so guys, so if you can see a little bit of cyan or left in the system, now hoping that this doesn't, you know, get worse, I have done a 200% water change on this, believe it or not. I did a water change on Monday and I did the water change on Wednesday. And it, you know, there was a vast improvement of the quality of the water that was taken out from here. So I said to my daughter, what we need to do now, we need to see how much we are feeding into the Pico. We need to just keep a record, so in the morning we'll do a feeding and just leave it. No more amino acids, and I think that was a contributing factor as well. We were doing about maybe 2 mil of amino acids every other day in here just for the corals, and that probably was an issue. Now we have one casualty or one wounded coral because of our mistake. So I said to Naira, look, I need to just ensure that I remind you and you remind me, you know, do it as a team so we can keep on top of the water changes and see how much we feed the fish in this tank. Now, this SPS coral is from my main tank and I had nowhere to put it and it refused to open. So the polyps did not extend in my main tank. I don't know why. It could be flow, it could be parameters. As soon as I place it into this Pico reef, look, all the polyps are coming out and doing really well. What's really set this coral back was the issue with the nutrients in the Pico, which caused a little piece to bleach out. I don't know everything when it comes to corals. I do get it wrong at times. I was not paying attention and it caused one of my corals, or Naira's coral, to suffer. One coral I think that's really benefited from the high nutrients in this tank is the gonioporo here. And it's a bit of a, well, LPS coral. And some people say this coral is very difficult to look after. I haven't had any issues looking after this gonioporo here. I've got two. I've got a very bright one on the back of this rock. And it seems to be doing fine. The chalice here, you can see it's actually encrusted, and at night time you can see the sweeper tentacles coming out to feed as well. I don't do any broadcast feeding at night in this tank. Like I said, it's a Pico, you know. The nutrients should be enough to keep each coral growing. Another coral that's really benefited from the amount of food or nutrients in the system are the zoas here. So you can see I've got that little snail, you know, cleaning up around the edges here. But this thing has really taken off. It was about, you know, one frag plug and it's spread into the corners. And what I'll do is I'll actually probably buy some more fancy zoas for Naira and put it around here. So she has like a little zoa garden to bring some color into this system. So guys, I've been re-educated, yeah, about keeping on top of your nutrients. So I don't know everything, like I said, keep on top of those nutrients and check to see where they are. Do your water changes and to avoid this crap happening to you. So hopefully this will heal up in a couple of months. This coral will be beautiful like it once was. Yes, people, so there you have it, a quick update on the Pico reef. Now, if you have to take a couple of points away from this video, I would say that ensure that you keep on top of your water changes and pay attention to your sand bed, because that could possibly become a nutrient sink, especially if you don't have a lot of flow like a conventional reef tank. Also, if you have a rear chamber, I would say to you, every now and again, every maybe 2-3 weeks, just get your filter media out, your filter floss, whatever filtration you have at the back here, get it all out, give inside a good little scrub. Also, because it's a small system like this, what I've done as well, I've actually put some more carbon in there. Now, I have not placed any GFO in there because I think it would be a bit too aggressive in such a small tank. So I've put a bit of carbon in there to keep the water clean. If there's any slime coming out from any corals, you know, the carbon can catch that as well. So guys, this is Narayan for HT Aquatics Reefing. Thanks for watching. Don't forget to like, subscribe and share. Follow us on Instagram. Check out our Facebook page. Yeah, and guys, just let's have a conversation. Comment, let's chat about what I could possibly do to keep this Pico going. Any suggestions, any good or fancy corals I could add, and I'm probably thinking about maybe getting maybe a rock anemone for this as well. So guys, just let me know what you guys think, let me know what your experiences are. Thanks for watching, see you next time.